it's no secret that I eat a lot of food. So in terms of my hierarchy, it's food and then it's water. I know technically it should be flipped around. So today we're at the RC Harris Water Treatment Plant. I'm gonna go inside, get a tour with the manager, Gord, and hopefully by the end of this, I'll get some clean drinking water.
My name is Gord Mitchell. I'm the manager here at RC Harris. I've worked for Toronto Water since 1990, since I graduated from school. I've been the manager at RC Harris since 2014. And I don't mind saying I think I have the best job in the city because I get to serve the residents of Toronto. I work with great people and I work in a beautiful building. This building has a pretty unique history and significant architecture. It was designed in the 1920s, built in the 1930s, expanded in the 1950s. It's designed in the classical Art Deco style of architecture. It's the biggest facility still serving its original purpose that's designed in that fashion. We're very lucky in the city of Toronto to have Lake Ontario so close by. It's a very clean, excellent source of drinking water. Our intakes are about 2.5 kilometers out into the lake. We bring the water in. It goes through large coarse screens, takes out any large material. Our lake is very clean, so we don't have much of it, but occasionally a fish might work his way in, some mussels. In the summer, you might get some algae or weeds, but not very much comes off on the screens. We have to feed a coagulant. We use aluminum sulphate, or alum as our coagulant. That's really important for our type of filtration we do here.
We're in one of the filtration rooms, and I think I had a really big misconception about water filtration. I thought that the water had to be moving extremely rapidly, but in fact, it doesn't. So you can kind of notice some rippling on that side there. That's where the water is entering into the room. And the reason that it can't be rapid is because you want the water flow to be extremely gentle so you're not stirring anything up. So even though it doesn't look like it, it's actually flowing water. I am particularly interested in this specific area because we call it the sludge cake area. So all it is really is when the water is getting filtered, part of the process is separating the residue from the actual water. So that's exactly what you're seeing here. From the filtration system, you're seeing the residue drop into this bin. And I know it kind of looks like soil, but that's actually 75% water and only 25% of it is solid. And that is the sludge cake. The hard part about coming into this water treatment plant is it's very hard to visualize all the different moving parts because obviously there's a lot. But I think here, this is the best visualization that you can actually get. So if you look at these different taps here, it shows you the different processes that they go through right here at the treatment. So coming out of this tap is the raw water. This is the water that comes directly from Lake Ontario, and these are the different stages. So for example, you have settled water, filtered water, and at the very end right here, this is the last final stage of output water, and this is the safe drinking water that we can have.